welcome to our lesson for today. Mm-hmm. So last time, remember, we talked about King Saul. And we talked about how King Saul was very sad and upset that Samuel had died. Yeah. And he was in despair because the spirit that was tormenting him had now become a spirit of despair. Yeah. And the Philistines were also about to attack. Mm-hmm. So he did not know what to do. And when he asked God, God would not answer him because Saul had chosen... Yes, God, he had disobeyed God and he had chosen to do things his own way. Yeah. So now Saul had this idea and he said he was going to go and he was going to find a witch and he was going to tell this witch to call upon the dead spirit of Samuel so that he can get advice for Samuel. But when King Saul did this, because remember, witches are against the law of God. So when King Saul did this, this was an even worse idea. This was a terrible idea. And because of this, this spirit that he talked to that he believed was Samuel told him that him and his sons were going to fall in battle against the Philistines. Mm-hmm. So he got even more terrible news and he got even more scared. So it had not helped him at all. Mm-hmm. But remember, we were also talking about David and we talked about how King Saul was after David to kill him. Yes. So now we're gonna see what was happening in David's life.
Yes. So David was still in hiding. He was still hiding from King Saul, but he kept thinking to himself, one day King Saul is going to find me and he will definitely kill me. So I need to come up with a plan. And so what David did is he decided he was going to join the enemies of King Saul because he thought with the enemies I'd be much safer. So he decided to join the Philistines in their land.
Yes. Yeah. So David thought, if I go and I hide among King Saul's enemies, then he will not be able to find me.
Yeah.
And this was actually a year before King Saul went and saw the witch about Samuel.
Yes.
So that's when David decided to go and he went with his all of his men and his family. So his 600 men and his two wives, and he went with all of them and they went to hide in the land of the Philistines.
Yes, so when they got to Philistine, to the land of the Philistines, there was this Philistine ruler whose name was Achish. So Achish really liked David and he thought David would be a great ally for him. So he decided to give David and all his men and their families the fortress city of
Ziklag.
So he gave them
the fortress city or town
of Ziklag.
Yes.
Yes. So he gave them that land for them to live there. And so David and all his men and their families settled and lived at Ziklag.
Yes, and that is where they had decided to live. Mm-hmm. But because King Achish liked David and his men, he would ask them to go on raids against the Philistines' enemies.
Yes.
But instead of going for raids against the Philistines' enemies, David would take his men and they would go and they would raid the Israelites' enemies.
Yes.
And they would make sure that they kill everyone so that no one survives.
Yeah.
And they would take the clothes and the animals and the donkeys
everything
and the camels and the goats
find.
And they would take everything they could find and they would take it back to King Achish.
Yes.
So King Achish thought they were raiding the Philistines' enemies.
Yeah.
But in real sense, they were raiding the Israelites' enemies. So
yes.
David was lying to King Achish.
Mm-hmm. So enemies of the Philistines was the Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
So Achish thought that David and his men had raided the Israelites, and every time he would ask, where did you get these raids? David and his men would say they got it from Israel or somewhere, the enemies of the Philistines. But in real sense, they were really raiding the other people that were enemies of the Israelites as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
So one time, the Philistines were prepared to go to war against the Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
So they all got ready and they all got prepared. Then King Achish asked David and his men to come and fight against the Israelites with him, to be on his side and to act as his special bodyguard.
Mm-hmm.
And when David heard this, he said he had to pretend that he was going to go and he was going to fight against his own people.
So he pretended that he wanted to fight against his own people, but in real sense, he did not want to. But it was too late. He had already lied to Achish about the raids, so he could not turn against Achish.
It was too late to tell the truth
at that time.
Because he had been deceiving Achish.
So he had to go to the raid.
Mm-hmm.
So David and his men left their families
at Ziklag
and they marched on to go for battle against the Israelites.
Yes, but when the other Philistine leaders saw David and his men, mm-hmm. they were very upset and they asked Achish, "What are these Israelites doing here? What are they doing here?" Mm-hmm. And Achish told them, "No, don't worry.
David and his men
are on my side.
They are loyal to me.
Yeah. I trust them. They are going to be good allies to mm-hmm. us. They will fight well with us against the Israelites." Yeah. But the rest of the Philistine leaders
did not have that.
They did not want to accept this. They refused to accept it. They said, "We cannot trust him. Mm-hmm. We cannot trust David and his men. As soon as he sees the Israelites, they're going to turn against us and they're going to fight against us. Mm-hmm. You have to send him away. Send him away and his men now. Send him away now.
Yes, so they decided, no. When the battle starts, David and his men will turn against us and start fighting for our enemies. So they have to go away. Mm-hmm. So Achish had no other choice but to call David and to tell him that... And he told David that, "I trust you, but the other rulers will not have you fight for us. So I'd rather you and your men just go back to Ziklag."
Yes.
So David pretended to be very disappointed. He pretended because Achish thought he really wanted to fight for them, but he did not. So he pretended to be disappointed and told his men, "We have to go back."
But in real sense, he was very grateful and was very thankful because he had said, God has saved me.
God has rescued me from this one.
Yes, so now I don't have to fight my own people. God has saved me. And he was so very, very thankful.
Yes, he was thankful that God had saved him even though he did not deserve it. He did not deserve it because at first it's him who decided to go to live with the enemies and even to lie and deceive Achish about all the raids and everything.
Yes, so David had made a bad decision.
Yes.
And when Liz making this bad decision led to him making more bad decisions and another bad decision and another bad decision.
Yeah.
And even though God had saved him, still things were not going the right way for David. So next time we're going to see what happens to David after he has made all of these bad decisions.
Yes.
But children, from this lesson we learn that it is very important for us to always make the right decision
from the start.
From the
because
start.
Because when you make one wrong decision, you'll have to cover it with another wrong one and another wrong one. And in the end, disaster will befall. So what you do, just make the right decision and stick by it. So always remember to make the right decision.
So now it's time for us to sing our song. So everyone stand up and help us sing this song.
Yes.
Okay, kids, so we've just talked about how David made a wrong decision and how he decided that he was going to go and hide from King Saul among the enemies of Israel, and also how he deceived King Achish into thinking that he was on his side. But God still saved him. So now we are going to sing a song about how God is good, because even though we make a bad decision, God will always come and save us. So everyone stand up and help us sing this song.
Yeah.
So we've just talked about how David made the wrong decision. And because of making one wrong decision to hide from Saul among the enemies of Israel, the Philistines, he made another one and another one. He chose to defeat King
Achish. That's the name, King Achish. Yeah. He chose to deceive King Achish, and then after that, and again, he kept on making the wrong decision. But God was able to save him. So we learned that we need to make the right decisions always. So to help us make the right decisions, we are going to make our craft. And our craft is going to be a signpost that says decisions. Always make the right decisions. And then on one side, we have the wrong decision. So the arrow is pointing in the direction of the wrong decision. And then an arrow pointing the direction of the right decision. So to remember, we always need to make the right decision. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to show you how we've made our arrows. So for my arrows, I took manila paper and cut out a triangle shape. And then at the bottom, I took manila paper and cut out sort of a rectangle shape with a triangle cut out at the bottom, an incomplete triangle. So then I'm just going to staple these two together, and then I will have an arrow. So you staple the incomplete rectangle with a triangle at the bottom, and then you staple the triangle at the top. And there you go, you have your arrows. So what I did is I made two arrows, and then I have two different lengths of a rectangular manila paper. One is long and one is wider but shorter. So this is my post, and then up here is where I'm going to write, always make the right decision. So I'm going to clear everything away, and at the top I'm going to write, always. Make. The right
decision.
Always make the right decision. But also at the top over here, I'm also going to write where our story is from. So this story, we find it in 1 Samuel chapter 27 to 30. So 1 Samuel chapter 27 to 30 is when we find the story of David and all of the decisions that he made, from the wrong ones and the disaster and everything that happens in his life. So then I'm going to take everything and I'm going to put it together. I'm going to take my sign and my post, and I'm going to staple them to my first manila paper just so that it can look more interesting. So I'm going to staple everything together. And then my signpost will be right underneath this. Okay, so now I have my signpost, but now I need to write in my arrows. So the first arrow is going to be at the very top. Oh no, my arrow came apart.
Sorry.
Let me just restaple my arrow very quickly. So my first arrow is going to be at the very top, and this one is going to say wrong decision. Big capital letters. This one is going to say wrong decision, and I'm going to staple it facing this direction.
So the arrow is on the left.
Yes, this direction is left. Yes. I don't think it matters, but I'm going to staple mine facing the left. I need to find a way to staple it. My stapler is not reaching. There. So I've stapled mine on the left, and this one says wrong decision. So at this top, I see always make the right decision. So now I need a right decision. So I'm going to take my second arrow and write right decision. Right decision. So now I just need to staple this second arrow. So there. So now at the top of my sign, I have always make the right decision. Then I have my arrow pointing to the wrong decision and one pointing to the right decision. So every time I'm about to make a decision, I will see this and I will remember I need to make the right decision.
Yeah, so like for example, you can think of what David did and write it. So the wrong decision he made was he lied. So on the wrong decision where the arrow points, the wrong decision will say lying.
And then where the arrow points the right decision, you can say, always tell the truth. So what you can do, just add a list of everything that you think is a wrong decision that you shouldn't make, mm-hmm. so that you'll always remember not to make the wrong decisions. Then on the other side, make a list of the right things or the right decisions that you can always make, so that every time you look at your decisions, you know whether they're right or they're wrong. Yes, so that's our lesson today. Until next time, bye.